What's going on, everybody? I've got something in my hand here. You probably can't see it. What do I have in my hand? Well, I'll tell you. It's a box. And what's in the box? Hang on and I'll tell you. But first, let's walk outside. Jump in the truck. There's a reason we're jumping in the truck. A couple weeks ago, got into a discussion with one of my friends about digital versus analog media, specifically cassette versus compact disc. And he suggested that cassettes stored their media without loss for a lot longer than CDs did. And several people chimed in on this. A couple people lived on the coast, so a CD would last maybe a year before it would corrode and stop working. Whereas cassettes would keep going as long as you kept it from being humid for a while. I found this box, and in this box, by found, I mean, I actually went looking for it. It's buried in my closet. There at the bottom, very last box I looked in. And in this box, cassettes. And why did I come out here to the truck? Well, the only cassette player I have is right there. Because this sucker was built in 2001 and cassettes were still a thing, I suppose. Turn the accessories on. Sweet. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to pick out what I think is probably my first cassette tape. I think, if I remember correctly, that this right here is the first cassette tape I ever owned. No, I'm not embarrassed. Kids, that is what a cassette tape looks like. Let's pop this in. This has never had a tape in it before. It still works. The tape deck works. And it sounds really good.
1773, he writes his first piano concerto. 1782,
I used to rock out to this all the time. It's pretty cool. It actually works.
1984, 1985, Austrian rock singer Falco records.
So that cassette tape is from 1985. It is 33, 34 years old. That's really cool. It still works. Let's go to the next one, shall we? Let's grab this one. Old classic. This thing has seen better days. Much better days. It looks like 10 or 11 year old me went in there with a tape splicing machine and had to splice a broken tape. And since I didn't have any glue or any proper tape, I used the only tape I had. And it looks like I used masking tape. So, yeah, I'm going to put this in. I'm going to hit rewind and see what happens. I am prepared for not nice noises. I'm gonna turn this up a little bit. Ooh, not nice noises, not nice noises. That noise would have been where I cut it to repair it. What you doing? What you doing? It's doing something. Oh, there we go. There we go. It still works. Conjures up memories of being in the movie theater for the first time watching the movie when it came out in 1984. So Yeah, it's not doing really bad for a 33, 34-year-old cassette. It sounds really good. Surprisingly good. That's pretty awesome. Let's go to the next part of our experiment.
All right, so what I have here are some of my oldest CDs. Dang, it's cold in this car.
And the reason I'm having to do this in the car is because I don't have a CD player. Not in the house. So, put the windows down and get some warmth in here.
Good grief, man.
Oh! There's already a CD in there. Get that out of there. I think this is my first ever CD, I think. Does this thing have an accessory where it'll not do that? Maybe. I might have to start the car to keep it from doing that. So much frustrating. Modern technology. Anyway, this is my very first CD, I think. I think this is the very first CD I ever owned. I'm gonna pop it in. When did I buy this? This CD is from, I'm gonna call it 88. It's released in 1988, and that's about when I would have bought it. I know this works. It should work. It should work, right? It should work. And it's still doing with the beepy beep thing. What the heck? Let's shut it off now. Ridiculous. Ford didn't do that. What's the matter with you? It's complaining about absolutely everything. No kidding. Sorry. Anyway, the CD player works. How do you make it skip? There we go. That one works. I'm gonna go ahead and go all the way to the end and see if the last track works. Reason being, on CDs, especially old ones, they have a tendency to start corrupting around the outside edge. I don't know why. Maybe sliding in and out of the sleeve, or maybe that's where you're handling it. Not sure. Car's gonna cry and complain again. Yeah. So, let's skip to the very last track.
That's great. It starts with an earthquake. Birds and snakes and airplane. Lenny Bruce is not afraid.
It's working. Sounds good. Somebody gave me this one. 93. It's another one of the oldest ones. Let's pop it in, see how it sounds. This one's been abused. Surface is shiny and clean. Doesn't want to play. Nope, 10 seconds in. Oh, yeah, silly me, had the volume all the way down. Still works. Sounds fantastic. Another, I wanted to do a complete apples to apples, but truck doesn't have a CD player in it because it's got iPod connectivity, and for me to retrofit it, with iPod connectivity, I had to take the 6-disc changer out from under the back seat. So now it only plays cassettes and iPod. I'm going to have to modify it again if I want it to play with the latest and the greatest iPod, because they changed their connector. So much frustrating. Anyway, let's go back all the way to the last track on this disc and see how it sounds. No artifacts, no skipping.
When you have you in the eye, just like an angel. Skin makes me cry. Float like a feather.
Turn that off before it starts dinging at me again. So that CD's from 93. How many years is that even? 26 years. So that piece of metal and plastic is 26 years old. That's pretty impressive that it still works. All right, so that's that. That was an interesting process. Cassettes from record labels from 33 years ago still sound fantastic. Cassettes recorded off of songs on the radio and from LPs, they still sound like garbage. But, yeah, that's what we had. The Audi's stereo sounds a lot better than the truck stereo, not surprising. Much higher end car, just a totally different setup. 5 years newer. Yeah, 5 years newer. It's hard to believe there's 5 years between the truck and the Audi. But anyway, that was neat comparison between compact discs, old compact discs, and old cassette tapes. I really wanted to try LPs, but I don't have a way to play them. I need a record player. I really need to get a record player. Anyway, hope you enjoyed this neat little journey for me down memory lane. Thanks for watching. You guys have a good one.